Hi everyone, today we're going to be talking about what the domain of a function is and why it should be important to us. The domain of a function is the available inputs, which we typically refer to as x, that will give us an output that is defined. So, put simply, the domain of a function is essentially the set of inputs that will give us an actual number output and not something that is undefined. Determining which inputs will make our function work can be found in several ways. Firstly, we could just plug in every possible number from negative infinity to positive infinity, make a giant table, and just see which one of those inputs do not work. However, this would be impossible, and even on a smaller scale, would be extremely time-consuming. So, how do we quickly identify which inputs will make our function fail? Well, we're smart people, so we list the reasons why an output could not be achieved. Firstly, what if we had any number divided by zero? Well, that's undefined and not a proper output. So let's write that down as the first reason why an output could not be achieved. Can you think of any other reason that an output could not be found? Well, what about a negative under a square root? Using only real numbers, we cannot solve a negative square root. So that is reason number two why we could fail to find an answer to our function. We can technically solve for negatives under square roots using imaginary numbers. However, this is something that will be taught in a much later course and not something you should worry about at this point. The two reasons we have just listed are the two main things to look out for when determining the domain of a function. In the next two videos, I will go through several examples of how to find the domain and how to represent them in interval and set notation. Lastly, for this video, I want to talk about why finding the domain should be important to you. If we didn't know the domain of a function, we would just have to assume that the function would work for every possible input, which is not necessarily the case. Therefore, through finding the domain of a function, we can be confident in knowing which inputs we are allowed to enter into the function. This is important because we want to make sure that all of our outputs that we receive from the function are useful and give us back something that is actually going to make sense and will not leave us with an undefined output. Thank you for checking out the video. If you enjoyed, please like and subscribe to support the channel. However, if you have any comments, questions, or concerns about the information I provided in this video, leave a comment below and I will do my best to address your concerns.